Russia has promised to reduce military activity near Ukraine's capital in the nation's latest round of peace talks. But an agreement might still be weeks away, if it comes at all, with attacks still being launched across the country.
At a secret military site in the west of Ukraine, rumblings of a ceasefire can barely be heard over the blast of bullets. While Ukraine's negotiators push for peace, the country's defenders keep strengthening their battle skills. This tight-knit territory defence team could be called to the front lines at any stage. The aim of the peace talks, to end the need for that. Today, the biggest step towards a ceasefire we've seen so far, Russian tanks filmed moving away from the capital, as Moscow declared it will dramatically reduce its military activity in Kyiv and the northern city of Chernihiv. Russia's deputy defence minister saying it's in order to increase mutual trust.
We'll see. I don't read anything into it until I see what their actions are.
The Pentagon saying Russia isn't fully withdrawing from the capital, it's likely just repositioning as fighting continues.
And nobody should be fooling ourselves by the Kremlin's now recent claim that it will suddenly just reduce military attacks near Kyiv.
A sentiment echoed by Ukraine's president. Ukrainians are not naive, he says. These signals do not shut down the rips of Russian shells. In this city, on the outskirts of the capital, the damage is done. Russian troops have been forced out of Irpin, but all that's left behind is desolation. Corpses abandoned on the street, building after building destroyed. And there was no let-up to the bombardment in the south, a Russian airstrike ripping a hole through a city administration building in Mykolaiv, killing at least 12. This soldier tells us the day the war began, he returned from Poland to fight, saying he feels hatred for Putin and the people who support him. Another soldier, Serhii, tells us even if we kill Putin or he dies, it doesn't mean it's over.
Just 2 months ago, we were filming at Territory Defence training exercises when they were preparing for war, many people believing it would never come. Now they're training in the midst of war, every one of these skills critical.
Far away from the peace talks, they send a message to Russia's president. Chanting glory to Ukraine, glory to the heroes, a straight shot from soldiers silently hoping the peace talks hit their mark.
Kari-Anne Greenbank joins us now from Lviv. And Kari, peace talks are entering their second day. What's being discussed?
Well, Georgie, it's understood that Ukrainian negotiators are offering a number of proposals to Russia. They include Ukraine becoming a neutral state, so not joining NATO, not hosting foreign military bases, and not pursuing nuclear weapons. That's something they gave up in 1996 anyway. In return, Ukraine wants other countries like France, Turkey and Israel to guarantee its security, and it is still holding on to aspirations of joining the European Union. Now, Roman Abramovich, the Russian oligarch, he was back at peace talks today after investigators led he was poisoned in previous discussions. The Kremlin has denied poisoning the Russian billionaire. Georgie?
Kari-Anne Greenbank, thank you.